Hey guys, welcome back to AJ's classes for UGC Net. This video is on data interpretation, which is a very important topic in paper 1 of the Net exam. In most question papers, a table or chart is given, and 5 or 6 questions are asked based on the data. It often involves simple mathematical calculations like percentages and ratios, but they still require a lot of practice. In this video, we're going to solve 6 data interpretation questions from the December 2015 UGC Net question paper. This is the table that is given. They've given us 7 years, each a decade apart, and the population for each decade in millions, and the electrical power production in gigawatts. The first question is, which decade registered the maximum growth rate percentage of population? We first have to calculate the growth rate percentage of each decade. The formula to calculate the percentage increase for a decade is the increase in population divided by the original population into 100. So first let's calculate the percentage increase for option A, 1961 to 1971. The increase in population for the decade 1961 to 1971 is the population in 1971 minus the population in 1961. So it's 24 minus 21 divided by the original population, that is the population at the start of the decade, that is 1961, which is 21 into 100. We get 3 divided by 21 into 100, which is equal to 14.29%. Using the same formula, we have to calculate the percentage increase for the remaining options. Option B, 1971 to 1981, the percentage increase is 12.5%. Option C, 1991 to 2001, the percentage increase is 6.67%. And option D, 2001 to 2011, the percentage increase is 9.38%. So looking at the percentage increase for the 4 decades, we see that it is the highest for 1961 to 1971, which is 14.29%. So option A is the correct answer. Moving on to the second question, what is the average decadal growth rate percentage of population? For the previous question, we already calculated the growth rate percentage for 4 decades. So we just need to calculate it for the remaining 2 decades, that is 1951 to 1961 and 1981 to 1991. Using the same formula, percentage increase is equal to increase in population divided by original population into 100. So for 1951 to 1961, it is 5%, and for 1981 to 1991, it is 11.11%. Since they have asked for the average for all the decades, all you have to do is add all the percentage growth rates of each decade divided by 6. So the answer is 9.82%. Be careful while taking the average because although there are 7 years given, there are only 6 decades and so we have to divide by 6. The third question is, based on the average decadal growth rate, what will be the population in the year 2021? In the previous question, we found that the average decadal growth rate is 9.82%. So to estimate the population in the year 2021, we have to check the population at the start of the decade, that is 2011. The population is 35 million. So the growth in population would be 35 into 9.82%, which is 3.4 million. Therefore, the population in 2021 will be the population in 2011, that is 35 million, plus the growth in population, that is 3.4 million. So the answer is 38.4 million. The fourth question is, in the year 1951, what was the power availability per person? Your options are A, 100 watts, B, 200 watts, C, 400 watts, and D, 500 watts. If you look at the table, you'll notice that the power production is given in gigawatts. So for the year 1951, the electrical power production is 10 gigawatts, which is simply 10,000 watts. The question is, what was the power available per person? So divide 10,000 watts by the population for the year 1951, which is 20 million. So 10,000 divided by 20 is equal to 500 watts. Therefore, the answer is option D, 500 watts. The fifth question is, in which decade was the average power availability per person maximum? The 4 options are given here. So we need to calculate the average power available per person for each decade. Let's calculate it for 1971 to 1981. Add the power production for the years 1971 and 1981. So that's 25 plus 40 divided by the population for the years 1971 and 1981. So that's 24 plus 27. We get 65 divided by 51, which is equal to 1.2745 gigawatts. Since we need to find the answer in watts, all we have to do is multiply 1.2745 into 1000, since 1 gigawatt is equal to 1000 watts. So the average power available per person for the decade 1971 to 1981 is 1274.5 watts. In the same way, calculate the average power available per person for the other three decades. We find that it is maximum for the decade 2001 to 2011, that is 2686.5 watts. So the answer is option D. The last question is, by what percentage did the power production increase from 1951 to 2011? Remember, the formula to calculate percentage increase is increase divided by origin into 100. In 1951, the power production was 10 gigawatts, and in 2011, it was 100 gigawatts. So it increased by 90 gigawatts, that is 100 minus 10. Just substitute it in the formula. It is 90 divided by 10 into 100, which is equal to 900%. That's it. I hope you found this video useful. If you did, go ahead and hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more videos.